Hey guys, Jake with 8020 Media here, back again today to bring you a video on common problems. Today we're going to be talking about common problems with Ford's 4.6 V8 engine. The 4.6 V8 was released in 1991 and is part of Ford's modular engine family, which is also known as the Triton engine family. However, the 4.6 was never badged as a Triton, and so it's not typically referred to as the 4.6 Triton, but rather referred to as the 4.6 V8. Now, it is the same engine makeup or same engine family as the 5.4 liter Triton and the 6.8 liter Triton. However, the Triton name was mostly a branding name and a badging name that Ford used predominantly on their trucks. However, the 4.6 V8 was used in a lot of other performance related cars as well and did not get the Triton nomenclature. It was most prominently used in the F-150 from 1997 until 2010. However, it was also used in the Mustang GT from 1996 until 2010 as well. It was used in a myriad of other Ford and Lincoln cars as well. And interestingly enough, it was actually used in the Koenigsegg CCR and CC8S, albeit that was a highly modified version of the 4.6 V8. Similar to both the 5.4 and 6.8 Triton engines, the 4.6 V8 was produced in both 2-valve, 3-valve, and 4-valve configurations. The 2-valve lasted until the early 2000s, and the 3-valve was used until 2010 or so, and then the 4-valve was predominantly used on the ultra high performance models. So jumping into common problems, as we've discussed in both of our other videos on the 5.4 Triton and the 6.8 Triton, the Triton engine family or the Ford modular engine family have pretty bad timing chain systems. They're known to have a lot of issues with the timing chain tensioners as well as the guide rails. And ultimately what this causes is slack within the timing chain. When you get slack in the timing chain, you'll hear some tapping or knocking noises that are coming from the engine. It's usually pretty loud and easy to notice at idle. So if you hear those, you're gonna wanna go ahead and inspect your timing chain and have it tightened or replaced. If it's not addressed, it can end to timing being thrown off. The chain can jump gears. Or sometimes even completely fall off, and that can lead to a lot more catastrophic engine problems. The timing chain systems on the 4.6 V8 are good for anywhere between 100 to 150,000 miles. Typically somewhere within that range is when they start to experience problems, when the timing chain starts to loosen up a little bit. So this is something to be aware of if you have one of these engines and you haven't serviced the timing chain and you're either within or past that service interval. The second problem we're going to discuss is with cracked intake manifolds. This problem is exclusive to 2001 and older engines. These engines used a plastic intake manifold, which isn't a problem at all. A lot of cars use plastic intake manifolds. However, the alternator mounting bracket is attached to the intake manifold, and so the intake manifold supports the weight of the alternator and its bracket, which puts extra stress on the intake manifold and can cause it to crack around the mounting bracket bolts. When this happens, it results in a coolant leak. Additionally, the temp sensor and the rear heater hose are known to come loose and cause coolant leaks from those spots as well. In 2002, the design was changed and they added a plate to essentially strengthen where the alternator was mounted, which resolved any of these issues. Fortunately, if you do have this, you will get a coolant leak, and so that's an easy way to tell. Just make sure you keep topped up on coolant. However, if you do have to replace the intake manifold, some aftermarket options aren't that expensive, and even the OEM ones aren't very expensive either. And so ultimately, it should be a pretty easy problem to catch and one that isn't that expensive to fix. The third problem to talk about is bad engine oil pressure. On the later model 4.6 V8s, the oil pump is known to go bad, and on the earlier models, the oil pressure sending unit can go bad as well. And so both the older and earlier models have issues with oil pressure. However, from two different things, the oil pump and the oil pressure sending unit. However, either one of these can fail on both older or newer models and is a common problem. And when one of these units goes or the pump goes, it causes the engine to completely lose oil pressure, which can have some very serious and significant ramifications if this isn't caught almost immediately. Running your engine without any oil in it or any oil pressure can cause extreme internal damage and therefore can lead to a complete, you know, engine out rebuild or the need for a new engine. And so this can become a significant problem if you do have one of these units fail and you continue to drive with no oil pressure. With that being said, the oil pressure or low oil pressure light should illuminate if one of these, you know, if either the unit or the pump fails. And so if you do see that, it's important to pull over and turn your engine off immediately and have it towed to a shop. And so this can be a catastrophic issue. However, hopefully should be able to catch it soon enough when the light illuminates to prevent any, you know, serious damage from occurring. The fourth problem that we're going to address is with the spark plugs. Now, on the 5.4, spark plug blowout is a big issue. It's also an issue on the 6.8 liter. However, it's less of an issue on the 4.6. Now, that's not to say that it isn't possible, because the 4.6 also does only have four threads on the spark plugs. However, for whatever reason, it just doesn't really seem to be that common that the plugs actually blow out. After 2002 or 2003, whenever they switched to a three valve design, they went ahead and lengthened the spark plugs and they got eight threads on them. And so blowout issues definitely aren't a problem for the third gens. However, the three valves do have an issue with the plug seizing and then breaking in half. And when this happens, it can be very difficult to get the broken piece of the spark plug out of the cylinder hole. And even for a professional mechanic, this can be quite a difficult task. So this can lead to some expensive repair bills if you do break a spark plug. The main reason these spark plugs break, honestly, is because of maintenance and because of the maintenance interval that Ford put on the spark plugs. The spark plugs have a 100,000 mile maintenance interval. And in my opinion, especially since these engines are used in some high performance cars like the Mustang GT, the replacement interval should be a lot closer to 50 to 60,000 miles. And so from the plugs having such a long lifespan, it's possible for them to seize in there. Also, if you don't use any type of anti-seize or if you over torque the spark plugs, those are two things that can cause this to happen more frequently. And so this is an issue. However, I would say with proper maintenance, if you change your spark plugs more frequently, put some anti-seize on it, as well as torque them to the proper specs, you really shouldn't have an issue with this. So that wraps it up with our problems for the 4.6 V8. Overall, we give this engine above average reliability. The timing chain system is a material problem area. However, it usually doesn't lead to any significant problems so long as you listen for, you know, the knocking or rattling noise and catch it early enough on. However, just know that these timing chains do need to be serviced a little bit more frequently than you'd have to service a timing chain on some other engines. The intake manifolds, not a huge issue since they're not that difficult to replace and not very expensive. Issues with the oil pump and oil pressure sending unit can become serious problems. However, I wouldn't say that this is the most common or a super common issue in the first place. And fortunately, you can pretty easily prevent it from turning into a serious problem if you shut your engine off and have it towed and get the issue fixed instead of driving it with zero oil pressure. And then lastly, the spark plug issues. You don't have an issue of spark plug blowouts here. It's really just with the spark plugs breaking in half. But if you properly maintenance this system, that shouldn't be an issue at all. And so while there are a couple problems here that can lead to some catastrophic damage, so long as you're aware of them and know what to look out for, these can be and are very reliable engines. And as I mentioned, the problems on here, while we do call them common, it's not extremely common for these engines to lose oil pressure. And it's not extremely common for timing chains to just completely fail out of nowhere. Everything typically happens over time, and so you should have ample amount of time to catch these problems before they turn into more serious issues. So, hope you guys liked this video. If you did, we would appreciate it if you clicked that like button, subscribe to our channel, and tune in for our other videos. And as always, if you're looking for additional information, feel free to check out our blog article that we wrote on this topic, which is linked down below in the description.